Hi everybody, today I'm going to do my October favorites. I want to begin by saying that I absolutely love fall. It's my favorite season, followed by winter, followed by summer, followed by spring. So fall is one of those times where I'm just like craving everything. I absolutely love colors, the scents, the fashion. So I have quite a few favorites that I wanted to share with you today, but I'm gonna try to make it snappy because I feel like I tend to go on and on and on about things. Alright, so let's start with some beauty products because I have quite a few here. I'm gonna begin with nail polishes. I went a little crazy and bought a whole bunch of OPI nail polish colors, and I'm gonna show them to you because they have been my absolute favorites for the month of October. I'm going to start with this color, which is Tickle My Francie. It's so, so cute. It's a desaturated light pink color, and it's the kind of color that it's perfect for fall, basically, is what I'm trying to say. It's definitely more appropriate if you have a cool skin tone, which I don't, but you know what? I decided to still go for it because I have some other colors that go with this nail polish that I'm going to show you in a second. Next color is Bubble Bath, which again is a super popular color. It's a really light sheer pink. It's super, super good for just kind of like a classy look, and I always try to look classy, so I decided to go ahead and purchase that one as well. I have two more colors to show you. The third color is Get Carried Away, which not only is a cute name, but it's also really, really pretty, like a purple pink dark color, which is the epitome of all fall colors. I just think it's so, so cute. And last but not least, I got Malaga Wine. It's just like a really dark deep red color, basically like a wine color, a red wine color, and it's not only perfect for fall, I think it's also going to be really perfect and appropriate for winter time, like Christmas time. So I've been absolutely loving nail polish colors, and although I don't have any nail polish on right now, I actually have been wearing nail polish, and I've been kind of cycling through these colors, and I've been loving them. Alright, so next I want to show you two other things, and they kind of go together, so I'll show them to you together. It's a Tarte blush in the color Seduce, which is a very good name for a blush color. And then I'm also going to show you a Clinique Chubby Stick, which is a lip color. And this shade is Whole Lotta Honey. Let me just take the cap off. So these two colors I am not only wearing right now, I've also been wearing them all throughout September and October. They just are such pretty colors, and I feel like they go really well with my skin tone. When you think of fall makeup, you think of like dark colors, and that's all fine and dandy, but not everybody looks good with dark lip colors and dark cheek colors, and I think I'm being one of them. I love dark lip colors, but I just don't think I really can pull them off all the time anyway. So for like an everyday look, I decided to go for a lighter color and more kind of suited for my palette. So I've been loving these. And last but not least, for beauty products, I want to show you my Urban Decay's Naked 2 palette. It's just such a perfect eyeshadow palette. Look at all the colors. Don't look at my nails too much, please, because they're not done. But look at the colors. They're so, so pretty. If you want to do like a daytime look and you don't want to do like bright green or weird colors, these are pretty much all 100% daytime appropriate. But if you wanted to kind of spice it up, you can go for the darker colors and do something, you know, more shimmery. And yeah, so I just feel like this palette works for every occasion, and I just have been loving this. It's kind of pricey. I think I paid $50 for this, so it's not the cheapest palette in the world, but it lasts all day, and you do get a lot of colors, and I've never really run out of eyeshadows because I really don't put on that much. So if you spend $50, I feel like it's gonna last for quite a bit of time. Alright, next I'm gonna move on to food. I'm not really sure if I'm supposed to include food in October favorites, but I decided to make my own rules and I'm gonna include food. So first thing I have to mention is pumpkin pie spice. This is expensive because I think it was $4 for this little tiny container, which is expensive for this little tiny container. But I decided to purchase it because I wanted to make a few pumpkin spice recipes, which are on my blog right now. I made pumpkin muffins and pumpkin spice latte, and both came out delicious. Anyway, this spice is the epitome of fall. This is a fall theme, obviously, if you didn't get it yet. Anyway, so I put this on oatmeal, I put this in my coffee, I sprinkle this basically anywhere I can. It tastes like fall, I don't know how else to describe it. And if you like the pumpkin spice flavor, this is one way to add that flavor to pretty much anything you eat. I also have been loving these bars. They are sold in Trader Joe's. I don't know if you have Trader Joe's wherever you live, but where I live in New England, we have Trader Joe's. And these bars are absolutely delicious. They're like a dessert, but they're a little bit more healthy than like a typical dessert would be, I think. One is peanut butter flavored and the other one is chocolate flavored. And if you actually put this in the microwave for about 10 seconds, you get like a brownie tasting thing and it's delicious. And both are under 150 calories, so it's not like you're gonna eat it and then feel guilty about it, which you shouldn't feel guilty about eating anything anyway, but in case you're on a diet or something, because everybody seems to be on a diet nowadays. Next is a little machine that's food related as well. It's called the Epica Milk Frother. I bought this off Amazon and they had quite a few different brands on there of this type machine. But I decided to go with this one simply because it had the most reviews, I believe, and they were all really good. And so far, I found that this is really, really good as well. What you do with this is you put milk in there, and there's like a little mixer thingy, and you turn it on, and it both heats the milk if you want it heated, or if you just want it cool, it just makes it foamy, and it makes it foamy if you heat it as well. That's my cat, don't mind him. Anyway, you can get the latte taste of like a coffee shop, and you don't have to go to a coffee shop, you can just do it yourself, and you feel like a pro when you do it, so that's really cool. So next, I'm gonna show you some of my favorite fashion pieces that I've been wearing, and some of my recent purchases as well. I'm gonna start with some sweaters because you can't talk about fall favorites and October favorites without mentioning sweaters. These two sweaters I bought from Lord & Taylor. I got them for like 90% off, so I couldn't pass it up. I got a whole bunch of sweaters, so I'm only gonna show you two, but I got like way more. This one here, which is a nice, pretty, like caramel sweater with, I think they're silver little shiny things. They could be also gold. Maybe they're gold, I don't know. But it's such a pretty fall themed sweater, and it was like $10. And then this one here is a light yellow sweater, which actually looks pretty white on camera, but it's actually really light yellow. It's so nice, it's so pretty, it's so soft, and it's just perfect for fall. You can layer this with like a jacket on top, or you don't have to wear a jacket on top if you don't want to. You can put a scarf over it. You can wear nice jeans with it. You can dress it up, dress it down. I mean, I don't know. I just think if you buy nice looking sweaters, you can do so many different looks with them and just look very fall-y. Next, I want to show you a leather jacket, which is on sale right now from Nordstrom. I got this jacket before I went to Europe, and I paid $100 for it. But now it's on sale for like $40, I believe, maybe $60. I'm not sure. I'll link it down below if you want to check it out, because it's a steal. I wish I paid that little for it, because paying $100 for it, I really thought it was worth it. And now that it's on sale, it's even a better deal. So do look at that for sure, because it's a really good deal. I mean, I wish I paid less for it, but it's okay because I love it now. And it's just so perfect, like even with the sweaters here. I mean, look at how nice that looks. Hang on. Technical difficulties here. Like, look at how nice this looks already. Like, this just looks like I'm about to go out and paint the town. So I don't know, this jacket, I've been wearing this in London, I've been wearing this in St. Petersburg, I've been wearing it in Massachusetts, and it's just, it's traveled all around the world with me, and it's just one of those like pieces that I can just throw on and instantly look good. So a leather jacket is a must for fall, I think. All right, next I'm gonna show you some booties, which, by the way, I love the word booties. These are from Cole Haan, and I recently purchased them, so they are pretty new to me, but I've been loving them already, and I just wanted to mention them in my October favorites. They are a black suede, and I just love them. I feel like they're dressy enough to wear with a dress, but also like casual enough and kind of chill and cool and laid back to wear it with jeans. And just, I feel like you can dress them up and dress them down, and they're just so versatile. And I featured them in one of my latest posts where I went pumpkin picking and I wore these little booties. I love the word booties. Alright, and next I'm going to show you a bag, which I've also been loving, obviously, because it's my October favorites. And this bag is Louis Vuitton. Dun, 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 dun. I am finally cool and fancy enough to have a Louis Vuitton bag. This one is one of their darker colors. It's just the big tote one. I love tote bags because they are big enough and light enough to allow me to put all my heavy stuff in there and just not feel like the bag itself is adding any more weight. And they're, like I said, big enough to hold all my stuff because I typically tend to carry way too much stuff with me. Like, I tend to carry everything with me, even the things that I would never need, but just in case of some odd emergency, I have that thing. Like, I don't know, random stuff. Anyway, so yeah, this is my little Louis Vuitton bag, which I want to hug. Alright, so next I'm gonna move on to some little homey home decor stuff, and I'll start with a candle because you can't do an October slash fall favorites video without mentioning a candle. And so today I'm gonna mention the Harvest Luxe Maple Pancakes candle. This one I got at Home Goods, so I'm not exactly sure if I can find it online and link it, but I'll try to find something that's super, super similar to this one if I can't find this exact one. Ugh, I wish you could smell it. It smells like heaven and pancakes, obviously, and maple syrup and just, I don't know, just happiness. The only negative thing about this candle is that it sometimes can make me a little hungry. Another thing I want to mention for the homey stuff category is magazines. I feel like fall is just the perfect time to get those home improvement, home decor magazines, and I love those any time of the year, but especially during fall. One of my two favorite magazines are Better Homes and Gardens and Martha Stewart Living. I know they're kind of like for older people, but I'm like 70 on the inside. You know, sometimes I feel like I'm an old lady, and I just love these. I love like homemaking magazines, especially during fall, because they have good recipes in them. They have different like fall activity advice. They have home decor advice, and it's just, it's really, really fun to read them. These are actually older versions of the magazines because I couldn't find the newer ones in my home, but the new ones are just as good and I love them. I mean, look at the cover. I mean, the cover by itself is inspiring. So last but not least, I want to mention podcasts. I love podcasts a lot. I have so many podcasts that I just love and listen to all the time, but the one I want to mention today is Lore. L-O-R-E. It's one of the top podcasts. If you go to iTunes top podcasts, you'll see it in the probably top 10 or something like that. And it's a podcast about spooky stories that are actually like true stories. Lore is like one of those podcasts I feel like anybody could like because it's stories, and us humans, we like stories. So anyway, yeah, it's a really, really awesome podcast and you should try it. And with that, I think I am done mentioning all my October slash fall favorites. I'm hoping this video is not too long. I hope that I am able to cut it down to maybe 10 minutes. We'll see. But I want to thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful fall. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye.